Hello guys, welcome to Learning Online with Prep Class. I am BC and I'm your tutor. Today we are going to be solving the Loyola Jesuits College Entrance Examination Quantitative Reasoning for the year 2020 from questions 41 to 45. Subscribe to our channel, like and make your comments on our videos so as to get more videos like this. Okay, so we are giving some set of samples. Study the sample below carefully. You need to take note of the keyword there. Study. So you have to study these samples before you move on to your questions. Study the sample below carefully and use it to find the missing numbers in the question that follow. So this means that once you're able to study these samples and then you get it, then you can move on to solving your questions. Okay, now what do we do in quantitative reasoning? We study, we think very well and understand the samples. Once you're able to understand the samples, then you'll be able to do any of the questions easily. All right, so let's look at the samples. You have to use your basic mathematical skills, okay, to solve problems. So we have to check if it is 18 times 9, that would give us 28. If it is 18 minus 9, that will give us 28. Or if it is 18 plus 9, that will give us 20. Just have to use your basic mathematical skills. Addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. That's all. So any of these could work. So let's see. But I would want you also to think for yourself as well. Think about this. Study it and try to see if you understand how to do it. So I want you to figure out the math necessary to solve these problems, and then you come back and check the solution. I hope you've been able to do that. All right, so let's move on now. So we've checked if it is 18 times 9, no. 18 divided by 9, no. 18 minus 9, no. But let's try addition. 18 plus 9 would give 27, but the bottom number is 28. So this means that when we add 1 to 27, we have 28. But we don't know if this is going to work. So let's just try this logic first. That to get the bottom number, add 1 to the sum of the two top numbers. So let's find the sum of the two top numbers, 18 and 9. 18 plus 9 is 27. 27 plus 1 is 28. The bottom number is 28. But we don't just stop it there. We have to check the two other samples to see if it works with them. If it doesn't work, then you have to look for another method to do it. The method used for sample A should work for sample B and should also work for sample C. Okay, let's check sample B. The top numbers are 9 and 10. So let's find the sum of the top numbers. 9 plus 10 is 19. And then let's add 1 to the sum. 19 plus 1 is 20. Yes, we got it. That is the bottom number. But we are still not done yet until we do sample C. Sample C, the sum of the top numbers are 11 plus 12, which would give us 23. Now let's add 23 and 1. 23 plus 1 is 24. So that is the bottom number. So this logic works for sample A, B, and C. So this means that for this set of questions, all you have to do is to find the sum of the two top numbers, and then you add 1 to it to get the bottom number, as simple as ABC. So once you have gotten the math behind it, and then you've been able to see that it works with all the three samples, then you can move on to solving the questions. Okay, so the first question in this video is question 41. So we have a missing top number and 4 as the second top number, and then the bottom number is 10. So this is very easy. Let's do this together now. Remember that to get the missing bottom number, all you have to do is to add the two top numbers and then you add 1 to it. But here we are looking for the missing top number. So what do we do? So we subtract the given top number from the bottom number and then we subtract 1. So we are doing like the reverse of what we'll do. Remember, for bottom number, we add the two top numbers and add 1. But for missing top number, we subtract the given top number from the bottom number and subtract 1. So it's opposite. Now, the bottom number is 10. And then the give it up number is 4. 10 minus 4 is 6. Then what do we do now? We subtract 1 from 6 again. So we have 5. So this means that the missing top number is 5. Let's find out if this is correct. 5 plus 4 is what? 9. And then 9 plus 1 is 10. So that is correct. The missing number is 5. So whenever you're giving questions like this, especially for the missing top numbers, just try it again and see if you'll be able to get the bottom number from your answer. If you're able to get it, then your answer is correct. Okay, which of the option is correct? A is 6, B is 9, C is 8, D is 5. So the correct option is D, 5. Now let's move on to the second question, question 42. So we are given the two top numbers as 10 and 10. We are asked to find the bottom number. How do we do this? I hope you know how to do it. So from the samples, we know that the bottom number is the sum of the top numbers plus 1. And the top numbers here are 10 and 10. So what is the sum of the top numbers? 10 plus 10 is 20. So we have 20 to be the sum of the top numbers. And then bottom number is giving us sum of top numbers plus 1. We've gotten the sum of top numbers to be 20. So now let's add 20 and 1. 20 plus 1 would give 21. So this means that the missing bottom number is 21. As simple as that. Which of the options is correct? Is it A, 24? Is it B, 21? Is it C, 22? Or is it D, 25? The correct option is B, 21, because that is our answer. I hope you're able to do this yourself now. Question 43. This is also very easy. I would like you to do this on your own. Okay, so we're given the two top numbers, 17 and 7, and we're asked to find the bottom number. Remember, when we were doing the samples, when we're trying to find the maths necessary to solve the samples, what we got that the bottom number is equal to the sum of top numbers plus 1. And we are given the top numbers here as 17 and 7. So let's find the sum of top numbers. 17 plus 7 is 24. And then we know that the bottom number is sum of top numbers plus 1. The sum of top numbers is 24. So 24 plus 1 is 25. So this means that the bottom number is 25. So we put it here, 25. The missing number here is 25. Which of the options is correct? A is 25, B is 29, C is 28, D is 26. The correct option is A, 25. Now let's move on to question 44. So we have a missing top number and we have a given top number, which is 4. And then the bottom number is 14. So let's do this together. Can you do it? You should be able to. All right, let's do it now. So we know that the missing top number is gotten by subtracting the non-top number from the bottom number. And after doing this, you subtract 1. So the bottom number is 14. And then the given top number or the non-top number is 4. So 14 minus 4 minus 1. 14 minus 4 is 10. And then we subtract 1 from 10. 10 minus 1 is 9. So the missing number is 9. Let's see if we are going to get the bottom number 14. Okay. 9 plus 4 is 13, right? Then 13 plus 1 is 14. So this works with the logic. And then we got the bottom number. So it is correct. The missing number is 9. Which of the options is correct? Option A is 10. Option B is 9. Option C is 12. Option D is 13. So the correct option is B, which is 9. Now let's move on to the final question in this video. Question 45. So we are given 6 and 20 as the top numbers. And then we are asked to find the bottom number. So this is pretty easy. Very easy. I would like you to pause this video, do this yourself, and then you check the solution. Were you able to get this? I trust you would be able to, because it's very easy. Okay, now let's do it together now. So we have the two top numbers to be 6 and 20. From the samples that we did, we know that bottom number is obtained from the sum of the top numbers plus 1. So we know that the top numbers are 6 and 20. So let's find the sum of the top numbers. 6 plus 20 is 26. 6 plus 20 is 26. Now, how do we get the bottom number? Sum of top numbers plus 1. We've gotten the sum of top numbers as 26. Now, what is 26 plus 1? 26 plus 1 is 27. Excellent. So the missing number is 27. As simple as that. So what is the correct option? Is it A, 31? No. B, 28? No. C, 27? Yes. So that is the correct option. 27 is the correct answer. So the correct option to choose is C. So this is very easy. To get the bottom number, all you have to do is to add the two top numbers and then you add 1 to the sum. That's all. Find the sum of the top numbers and add 1. As simple as that. I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to like and comment on them. And then you can subscribe to our channel. You can also join us on WhatsApp by clicking on the link in the description below. Till I come your way next time, bye for now.